Hello, everybody. It's Dr. Zaino with 15 Minute Fuel. We're just in 15 minutes a day. We're going to fuel your mind, your body, and your future. Well, I'm waiting for everybody to get on because everybody loves this time of the day. I'm going to go over some announcements as usual. All right, episode 34 went live yesterday for the We Are Heroes. You'll see the link probably during this this broadcast, so check that out. It was really fun. You know, we were in Atlanta at the time with Dr. Dan Pompa's Live It to Lead It seminar. It was a great time. I got to speak in three different fashions in that day. I did a mastermind in the morning, because anytime I speak anywhere, and I have the link, when you buy the tickets through me, I give you a private mastermind with some great, great docs. Then I got to do a Q&A with Whitney, the power couple. We did our thing on stage, and then I was able to deliver the hero message for the Platinum Team, a group of just very extremely powerful doctors that I was honored to speak in front of, and it was just great. And if you do watch it, make sure you watch it all the way to the end. It'll make you smile. All right, of course, join social media. Thank you so much. And also, if you have not gone to IamHero.com, you're missing out on my free 1 month to live video series. I made a video program for you guys called 1 month to winning. It's five videos, short videos, once a day, 5 days a week. On the weekends, you kind of reflect, and they have little exercises, beautiful one page PDFs. I made it to where all the content could be absorbed in under 5 minutes per day. You know, I want to keep things tight and effective, because I know a lot of times, if you're watching this, you set out to do some things, right? You set out to, whether it be lose weight or set a goal. And what happens is you go online, you get a program or a book. Now watch what happens. The program in the book says, we're going to take you from where you are, point A to point Z. And it's a huge program. And what do? You buy the program, and either you don't use it, or you buy the program. And then when you start to use it, you do good. And then it just, life happens, right? And you just kind of get burnt out, and you're like, man, and you feel that you failed. So I'm providing you a new opportunity here. So this is unlike any other experience you had, where it's one little thing per day, one little thing. So we want little wins. Remember, don't go for the Hail Mary, go for the little wins. So you do a little win, boom, a little win, boom, because it's not about an act, doing it once in a while. Winning is a habit. So this develops that habit in you over 1 month. And you feel the accomplishment of, hey, I watched that one short video. I did that one act. Done. One. And then you do that over a month. And then if you want to, keep on watching and doing the course over and over again if you want. These are great principles. And I'm actually currently working on other things as well. So that's kind of the thing I'll do. And again, it's given to you guys. So go to IamHero.com, type in your email, and enjoy it. You got a great ebook. It's great. All the stuff you need. All right, so let's get in today. Okay, hey, Dr. Jeff, good to see you. I am having an amazing day. Hey, Mom. All right, so today, my message for you guys is your dream was meant for you. I'll say it again. Your dream was meant for you. And it's kind of, I'm kind of going and continuing on what we talked about yesterday, that when you have this dream or gift or message, you know, that it's, you know, you're the hero has been given a message, a call, they stand for something. And that pull or that drive to get that message out to change the world, that was specifically destined for you to give. You follow what I'm saying? So when you have an idea or a dream or a vision, be careful who you talk to about it. Right, because you could go and tell, you know, if I try to tell my vision or my dream or what's going on and what God's placed in my heart to some other people, even people who care for me, the dream wasn't for them. The dream wasn't for them. The dream might be for them, meaning that they could absolutely benefit from it, but they were not chosen to deliver that. So what happens is you speak to family, even friends, and then of course the naysayers, and then just to help you, they'll just try to talk reality into you. Or it'll almost be like casting pearls onto the swine where, you know, it's just not even accepted, or maybe you'll even be discouraged. Think about it. It's probably happened before in your life. You had an idea, and then you talked about it, and then immediately you were shut down. And then what that does is it makes you not believe in the message you were given. It makes your dream invalidated, where it was for you. It wasn't for that other person. And so what happens the next time you have the dream or that vision or that great idea, you're less and less likely to go and go for it. You know why? Because every time you told somebody about it, they told you how it was impossible, it couldn't be done, right? Or they hated on it, that's another one. Or the people that care about you, They tell you how realistic to think because they do love about you. They really care. So you got the haters, of course. You got the naysayers, and you have the people that love and care about you that are just trying to protect you from maybe investing in something. Or some of you want to leave the job you're at to pursue what you were fulfilled to do. But so many times in life, what do? We get a job or we find a profession or we work to help, you know, make money, right? Make a living. And hopefully we'll make a living so we'll be fulfilled later on. But it never happens that way. So instead of, it should be, find something that you love to do. That's the dream, that's the gift and talent that was placed in your heart. Start doing something that you would really do for free. Like, so I tell you guys, if you're a writer, start writing. If you speak, start speaking. If you have a video, send your message out for free. Like I'm literally doing the thing for you guys. So all this stuff, there's no charge. I'm doing it because it actually is fulfilling to me and it fills me up. And when I'm fulfilled, I'm happy. I'm not depressed. I have joy. I'm a great husband. I'm a great dad. I'm a great doctor. I bring greatness and that hero to every walk of life. But I haven't been paid $1 for it. Watch. So get to that point, and then if you're a good business person, you could then slowly monetize it in a very ethical way, because wouldn't it be great to do something that totally fulfills you and you're happy and it's your dream, it's your vision, it's your calling, and then you get to also make a living on it versus working your whole life trying to save money up so someday you could do the thing that you always wanted to do. Let me say that again. How many people save money and work and work and work and sit at work disengaged, meaning how many of you are disengaged at work, meaning that you're making a living and you're thinking about what you can't wait to do in 10 or 20 years? Think about that. If you're dreaming about your dream at work, you're disengaged totally. And people see that. Versus doing what you love to do now. What's fulfilling? What's the message inside your heart? Doing it, even if it's free, even if you don't know where you're going to monetize it, and start going out and doing what you love to do. And then you'll be able to find a way to monetize it and make a living doing what you love. So instead of trying to find something, then hopefully get fulfilled from it, do what you're fulfilled, your dream, what you're called to do, and then slowly monetize it. So that's really the fourth pillar. The number one pillar is embrace the hero mindset. We talk about that. Number two, we have to not discover, remember our superpowers. And I was talking to a great meeting planner this weekend, awesome guy. And he says, look at the signposts of your life, the signpost. If you look in your life, you know, like I remember, like I was the hero the whole entire time. Look at the signposts. What are the things that you just gravitated towards doing in your job? So I remember, I look back, you know, I built my entire chiropractic practice through speaking, through talks. So I literally didn't realize, but that was the signpost of my life. And when you look back when you were younger, you could see there was things that were always in your life, whether it be teaching, whether it be enjoying music, there was something looking back in your life that you forgot that was there the whole time. And now as an adult, it's going to bring you right back to that. So look at the signpost, see what you love to do, remember your superpowers and talents, and then develop them and then give them to the world. And then find your vehicle. So your vehicle is speaking, writing, video, audio, or a combination, teaching, and then that's how you do it. So now I got you all the way to a point where you're doing what you love to do, and the fact that you do it on a daily basis, there's no depression, your freedom, you have amazing energy, your status goes really high because now you're the hero, you feel great, you're optimistic, you're enjoying and loving life. And now I realize the fourth leg of that has to be monetization of it, right? So how do we monetize it? So if you don't know how to monetize it, then it's you could find someone and partner up with someone who is good at that. Or if you are good at business, you'll learn how to way to do it. But when you monetize it, you're monetizing your dream, your message, right? I'm not writing a book or doing a video to hopefully make money from it. You know, the video in the book happens to be an extension of your dream. You follow? So you got to get the dream here and make it an extension. All those things, all those vehicles become an extension of your message, and it's a great way to get your message out to the world. So now I come full circle. Your dream is meant for you. Sometimes it's not meant for anybody else. And a lot of times we have this dream and we want to tell someone, and when we tell someone, we get discouraged, or we get discouraged on our own, saying, I don't know how I'm going to do it, because there's all those fears and fogs. And it's very easy to get discouraged, but remember that dream was for you. It wasn't for somebody else. So be very careful. Protect your heart and mind on who you share it with. And even your best friends might be trying to help you and make you see how you need to think realistic. But always remember, don't get discouraged. The dream was for you. It was for nobody else. You know, the secret identity, it doesn't like that you dream, because then you no longer could be limited and mediocre. The dream is for the hero. And so that's why, you know, I just realized this weekend, you know, I even get discouraged every day. I was discouraged this morning because it's weird. You know, you have a great weekend, you're doing great, and then you realize in the greatness of whatever happens, then you realize how big the world is and how big life is. And you're like, and you always say, hey, listen, can I do what this message requires of me? You know, it's a simple question you ask yourself, and you have your good days and bad days. But as long as you go to center and realize that, hey, wait a second, this message that livens me once again, this message that melted calluses off my heart, that was the message, that dream and message was for me to give to the world. It was nobody else's. So despite if someone likes your idea or not, if they love it or hate it, it has no relevance to who you are. You can't let the outside dictate your validity and exactly your worth as a person. So the message is for you. So whatever you're thinking in your heart right now, oh, claim it. This is my message. This dream was given to me. And you know what? Also, you have the responsibility that message and dream was given to you to then go and fulfill it. And that's why, you know, this weekend I got sad when I didn't get the email. I thought, you know, I didn't make it to the finals. But because, and what I was sad about wasn't myself. I was sad for the message. I was like, wow, you know, I felt that I let the whole message down, you guys down. But I realized, you know, the dream is, it was given to me to take out. So good or bad, thick or thin, the dream and the message and the vision is for you. So if you're discouraged about where you are right now in life, or if things are going great right now for you, remember, it's that purpose inside you that was meant for you. And no one else is going to understand it like you. You know how you get excited about something and you know something is for you and you know this is a message or an idea? You get excited because it's for you. And no one else is going to have that same type of feeling. You know, so that's why you absolutely need to be able to find and embrace this is for you. It's been given for you. And you were born for this, basically. So don't let anybody discourage you. Hope you got some good stuff from that. If you liked it, please hit the thumbs up. Hit that share button. Love it. Make sure you visit iamhero.com. You have my free 1 month to win. It's literally a habit. We're going to help build the habit together on winning. You have everything there, and it's a new opportunity, meaning that for the video people like myself, there's the videos, short videos. For those you have to read, it's one-page reading. It's done in under 4 minutes. And then for the writers, we have application exercises. So make sure you do that. Sign up, enjoy it, and then contact me so we could go through this journey together. Also, thank you guys so much for all the cool clothes that you're getting. I mean, check this out. I saw a guy at the gym today, George, wearing the 0% secret identity shirt. So it really is, it's very cool that you guys embrace it. Because the shirts help me remember. Remember, you see, for those of you who remember, you're the heroes now. You know, some of us went 20, 30, 40, 50, 60 years because we forget. So sometimes it's nice to have something to remember you by. So have an amazing day. I'll see you tomorrow, Wednesday, with 15 Minute Fuel. We're just in 15 minutes a day. We're going to fuel your mind, your body. Stay with me, and your future. God bless.